My name is Tom Crow, and my wife and I, my wife's Mary Jane Crow, and we own Southern Bell Mercantile here in Huntsville, Texas. The history of the building goes back originally to 1841. It was a wooden structure at that point, and Gibbs and Coffin ran a mercantile. After they'd bricked it in, the Gibbs family loaned a lot of money to people, a lot of it with no interest. They would let them pay them back with crops or whatever they could. And so in 1890, it officially became Gibbs National Bank. And what they did, they moved the mercantile next door, and the bank remained. They put the bank in here and moved the Gibbs offices upstairs. And so anybody who was single who worked for either the bank or the mercantile could live above the mercantile free of charge. It was something that they could do for their employees, which I found very interesting. In 1923, Huntsville National Bank purchased the Gibbs National Bank, and so it ceased to exist as Gibbs National Bank. They were designated as the oldest running business in Texas at a single location. And they continue to operate because they're upstairs on the second floor, so they still, even after 1964, obviously are the oldest operation on a single location in the state of Texas. Where we're standing right now was an alleyway. And because the mercantile was next door, and they backed trucks in and unloaded them into the mercantile, and then they bricked in or cemented in the backside over here for the vault for the bank. Well, I think the brick, for one thing, and then right back here is a steel door that's from the early 1800s. All those things just go together to bring back the Gibbs history and the things that they did to keep Huntsville going back in the day. We noticed that foot traffic tended to come this way, and we learned about the history of the building, and my wife taught Texas history at one time, and so she said, we've got to move down there if they'll work with us, and they've been wonderful to work with, and so that's how we ended up down here. When we decided to open our shop here, we wanted some renovations done because it wasn't in the condition that we would like it. And so when we came back to this room, there was sheetrock over these bricks. And we said, well, what's behind that sheetrock? Because we didn't know. And when they started taking it off and we saw these bricks from 1860, we said, are they strong enough to uncover and leave exposed? And so they had it evaluated. And so we wanted to take it back to its original history and uncover the bricks and everything, because these are from 1860, these bricks are. And so you're talking about 160 years old. I like to kid and say that I'm the mule that hauls stuff. But we have some vendors in here, and then we have a lot of our own furniture, and I have some knives and stuff in here. But typically it's just take care of customers. You know, people are always looking for something different, and that's the cool thing, is when we sell some things, we bring other things in, and so the inventory changes all the time. It's not the most expensive things. It's when I can learn the history of something, when I know where it's been, what has it done previously. And so it's not so much the money value, it's the value in knowing about the item.